Topic bucket.
All right. What is the most effective response you can give when you're caught watching porn?
I'm studying for our anniversary. Me and these other four very tall black gentlemen in white t-shirts behind the sofa.
I think caught by who? Does that matter?
Ah, great question.
I mean,
dad catches you versus girlfriend catches you versus superintendent
wife
catches
versus
you.
Kid?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, wife, girlfriend, whatever.
Just, I don't know. So what?
Maybe I wouldn't have to do this if blank. And that'll always
end well. I definitely got
well.
In the car one time and the Bluetooth connected and moaning came through the speaker.
Oh, dude. I haven't had the moaning, but the category
title.
And title came up. And, man, did they learn a lot about me.
I have a Bluetooth, like, light in my bathroom. It's got a speaker and everything. And it'll just connect to your phone sometimes, just walking in the house. And didn't even know. I was in the basement, and my girlfriend walks in the bathroom, and she, like, hears.
Wait, are you in the basement watching porn masturbating?
No.
Coming through the Bluetooth speaker in the bathroom.
No, I probably had just finished, and was downstairs messing with my drums. It was still on my phone.
Your drums.
Is that what you call
it? Yeah. That's the nickname for your balls.
Yeah, drum solo. Speaks?
Somebody caught me watching porn. I would say, that's really her face, okay?
Her face. All right. What soup could you eat for the rest of your life?
Oh.
Wow.
Oh, can I start?
Please.
Mine is a quick answer. Pea soup. I love pea soup.
You got pea soup with ham, though, because you're Jewish.
Yeah.
Pea soup with ham is next level.
It's great.
Big hunk of pork in there
smoked
for flavor.
Ham, it gets like that smokiness to it.
Got good filter fish in it.
Oh, God. That hung a right. Diner, I tell you, double T diner matzo ball soup.
Matzo ball soup is great.
Dude, double T diner in Annapolis, their matzo ball soup, it's like $2. It's amazing.
What about a chicken corn chowder?
I'll eat chicken corn chowder.
What about a half and half Maryland crab, cream of crab? What about a tomato rice? What about an Italian wedding?
Oh, wait a minute, tomato rice. Italian wedding's on my Mount Rushmore. Italian wedding, minestrone. Does beef stew count as a soup or is that a stew?
It's a stew.
It's a stew.
A stew. Yeah, okay. How about, you ever had a mulligatawny?
Sorry, what?
I'm sorry, what? Mulligatawny?
You gonna say that to my face?
That was on Seinfeld. Soup Nazi episode.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, I know. I heard it somewhere.
Mulligatawny soup.
It's Indian. It's delicious.
Yeah, I don't know the specific ingredients.
It's a curry soup, chicken, vegetables, apples, and rice.
It's you don't taste the apples.
Yeah.
It's more curry, it's delicious.
Scott,
my favorite.
What's the desert island soup forever?
Tomato rice.
Topic bucket.
All right. Let's see here. Which brand are you actually loyal? Which brand are you actually loyal to, and why?
Cottonelle. I do not ever waver with my toilet paper. I only buy Cottonelle, and it's the only thing that goes between my butt cheeks. I love it.
Love it.
God. I mean, this is me being a radio nerd with Sennheiser for headphones.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just the only brand I like. For whatever reason, the only ones that can power through all the wax in my ears.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like I have these pair are falling apart, and I'm going to ride them till the wheels come off because they don't make these anymore. I've tried to eBay them. I bought the new version of them, and they're nice, but Sennheiser headphones.
Yeah, the only thing I can think of is Irish Spring soap. Mm-hmm. And I bought the liquid kind.
No.
And I can't.
No.
I can't open it. So I got a problem, but
what do you mean?
It's I don't know the way the top is positioned.
Huh?
It's deformed, and I can't open it.
Would you bring
defective.
It in tomorrow?
Yeah, actually,
Irish
I will.
Irish Spring
bring
body wash.
Yeah, that's right. I want to actually have my fingers on my body.
God, I miss the old Irish Spring.
I'm looking at some.
Oh, I found it. I found the commercial. Hell yeah. Oh, there they are, horseback.
Fresh and clean as a whistle. That's Irish Spring. Fresh and clean as a whistle.
I don't think he's a natural Irishman. Remember, they do this in all the commercials. the guy would take a knife and whittle the bar.
Yeah.
He'd cut open a he'd whittle open a slice of Irish Spring. That's, you can't have the whole bar, but you could have a sliver.
That was part of the appeal. Well, as the Irish Spring aficionado in the room, can you explain Irish Spring to me?
I like the smell. Actually, my roommate in college used
I don't get it.
Oh, it's just a bar of soap, and I started using it like 20 or 30 years ago.
But what is it?
Oh, it smells, you mean, like, what does it smell like?
Or? Why is it Irish? What makes it Irish? Why is it Irish Spring?
I don't think...
is the smell? What is the? Is it from Ireland?
I have no idea.
It's a complete gimmick.
Yeah,
what does it even smell like?
Let's see what we have here. Lenanin Side Slobbering Pine Tempest Loop Garo.
Hold on, say it normally. What is it?
I can't pronounce half this stuff.
I mean, you know, like White Rain, there's not really a cloud over the bottle. I have no idea.
I'm going to copy and paste this into the language translator because I can't pronounce half this crap. So I'm going to see if the computer wants to take a crack at this. All right, here we go. Let's get rid of you. And computer, take it away.
Lenin City, Slobbering Pine, Tempest, Lou Garo, Lightning and Ullaloom.
That
smells
from their
like
website.
You came from a nice smelling place.
That's the description.
Slobbering pine. Hey, when you see a tree and you just want to place your moist, wet mouth upon it, slobbering pines. It's like a regular pine, but a whore caught a hold of it.
What were the rejects in that conference room?
How about Scottish fountain? No. How about English pond? That's a little slimy.
Not English pond, we're close.
Okay, we're on our way. British stink. I feel like we're just there, but we're not quite there. Oh, God, what we got here? Russian knuckle. No?
I just remember Lever 2000. I thought I was like showering with the future.
I was like 2000
like,
Lever
dude,
parts.
This is like it was like futuristic looking, and it was like the box was metallic and it had 2000. Remember when 2000 meant like the future?
Everything. Yeah. They used to name stuff something 2000, the Legion of Doom 2000, something something 2000. Hi.